Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to automate our first test case using Selenium WebDriver. Let's see what is the test case we are going to automate. We are going to launch the browser, Google Chrome browser, and then navigate to a website, selenium.dev, which is the official website of Selenium. And then we are going to verify the title of this web page. And how do we get the title of the web pages? Right click on this web page. Click on View Page Source, which gives us the HTML code behind this web page. And to find the title of this web page, just do Control F and type title. So you can see the title here, right? So between these tags, we can see the title value as Selenium. So the title of this web page is Selenium with S being in uppercase. Remember that. And once we are done with that, we are going to close this browser window. Right, so this is the simple test case we are going to automate now. And if you remember, we already wrote code for launching the browser. So this we did in our last video. So now what we are going to do, let me list down the steps. We are going to navigate to the website. And then we are going to read the title and check the title, if it is according to the expected value or not. And finally, we are going to close the browser, right? And before that, let me execute till here, whatever we did in the last video. So to launch the browser, let me execute that code first. So if you see here, the Chrome browser got launched, but if you observe, this is not maximized. This is not full screen, right? So what we'll do is we'll first maximize the browser window before we start our test case, right? And how do we maximize the browser window is driver object dot manage is a method dot window dot maximize is a method which actually maximizes the browser window. Let me execute and show you. Okay, let's save the code. And you can see, it just maximized, launched the browser and it got maximized. All right, now let's start automating the test case. So the first step, navigate to the website. How do we navigate to the website? Again, driver object dot get is a method where we can provide the parameter as the URL to the website whichever we wanted to navigate. So let me type the website address of Selenium official documentation. So this is how we navigate to the website. We use the get method for that, right? Now let me execute the program and show you. See, it got maximized and now we should be navigated to the selenium.dev website. So we are on to the Selenium website, right? Okay, let me close this. And now let's move on to the next step. We wanted to read the title. How do we read the title from the web page? Once the page is loaded, driver.get title. We have a method called getTitle, which actually gets the title of the web page. And getTitle is a method which is returning string. If you see here, it is returning string. So let's capture this string in a string object, title. Right? Now we wanted to check if the title which we read on the web page using the getTitle method is equal to the web expected value or not. So what's the expected value? We know. It has to be Selenium with S being in uppercase, right? Equals. It has to equal the title. Title is what we captured, right? Using the driver object. So it has to equal the word Selenium, right? Now, if it is equal, let's print something on the console, like maybe title matches test case passed. Else, titles do not match and test case fail. Let's execute the program till here. So it launches the browser, maximizes the browser window, navigates to the selenium.dev website, and then should read the title and verify the title. So we can check here. It is still loading the page. And we can see here, titles match, test case passed, right? So if you observe till now, what we are doing, once the test case is done, I am doing manually closing this browser, right? So now we wanted to automate this step as well. So close the browser once we are done with the test case. So how do we do that? Again, driver object dot, we have a method called close, which actually closes the browser window which the web driver is focusing on. Let's execute it now. Navigates to the website. And once the page is completely loaded, it reads the title, verifies the title, and checks it with the expected value. And then it has to close the browser window. If you observe, see, the browser window has been closed here. We didn't close it manually this time. And you can see titles match, test case passed, right? However, we see a warning here, connection reset socket exception. So this exception is coming in the version 4, Selenium 4.1.0. And this is a known issue, seems like this is a known issue. And this is expected to be fixed in the upcoming latest version, right? So for now, we can just ignore this exception. And also what we can do is we have another method called quit. Quit is a method which also closes the browser window. Then what's the difference between close method and quit method, right? So close actually closes the window which WebDriver is currently focusing on. But quit method closes all the process windows and tabs, whatever are opened by the web driver. So this is the main difference between close method and quit method. So one of the very important interview questions, right? So let me execute the program now. We use quit instead of close. And I'm executing this same program again. So it just navigates to the website. Once the web page is loaded completely, verifies the title, and it has to close the browser window. In our case, we only have one window, and you can see here, titles match, test case pass, and browser window got closed. So in this case, using close and quit, both are same, but when WebDriver actually opens more than one window, right? So then quit method will be of handy. Once we wanted to close all the windows, tabs, process opened by the web driver, we wanted to close all of them. So with one method quit, we can close all of them once we are done with our test case. So that's the use of quit method. So we actually automated our first test case using Selenium WebDriver. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.